I agree with, I think, the majority of people, and it's not just inside the Washington think tank, or this incestuous, whatever you
incestuous
call it.
Incestuous amplification.
I agree with Steve Ratner, Obama's car czar. Yeah. I do agree with Richard Haass, president of the CFR. I agree with Jeffrey Sachs, pretty preeminent progressive.
Who all believe
that we have a long-term debt problem, and whether they believe that over the next 2, 3, 4 years we need to obsess over the deficit or not doesn't change the fact that we have a generational problem. And Paul has been calling it
that.
Hold on a second. Let me talk. Okay, because Paul's been allowed to talk an awful lot.
Fair enough.
Paul can call it ad hominem attacks all he wants, but what we believe is what Paul once believed, and that is, well, it's actually not even a matter of belief, it's reality. You know, we have a generational crisis. You know, in 1933, 1934, when FDR created Social Security, life expectancy was 62. You got your first check at 65. It's a pretty good deal, even a small government conservative like that type of deal. We're growing, you know, we're living, you know what, if you could just stop from saying, wow.
I'm sorry. I've written about this so many times.
Let me just finish.
I'm sorry. That was an involuntary reaction.
You and Al Gore really need to talk about it because, again, this is a real problem. If people don't agree with you 100% of the time, you talk about ad hominem attacks, you always feel like you have to take the cheap shot. So if I could just finish.
Go ahead.
I've listened to you. The fact of the matter is we've got a generational crisis. Americans are living longer than they did in 1933, 1934. And Paul has written about this. You could see this coming, as my torts professor said, like a freight train coming out of the mist. We could see this coming a long way off. You've got about 3 Americans working for every 1 person on Social Security and Medicare. 10, 15 years from now, that's going to get closer to 2 people working for every 1 person on Social Security and Medicare. We're talking about the Eisenhower era. Back then, it was 15 people working for every 1 person on Social Security. The numbers just don't add up. And I think a lot of us, other than Paul and the 2 or 3 people that he was talking about, believe that we can do 2 things at once. We can grow the economy in the short run. We can also do what's responsible for our children and for our grandchildren and be concerned about long-term debt. That seems pretty damn rational to me.
Okay, last word.
Last word. You're mushing together 2 completely different issues. The crucial issue right now is, are we going to keep on cutting spending and derailing this recovery? Or are we going to at least try to spend some more, provide the extra stimulus, bad word, but the extra stimulus that this economy needs? Nobody disagrees that if we look at the year 2025, there is going to be a problem about it, how we're going to pay for this government.
That's 12 years from now.
Right.
12 years.
Well, in 2025, it is a problem, but not a really severe problem. It gets worse as we go further because population ages, healthcare costs rise. So there is a long-term problem. The question is not, is there a long-term problem? The question is, do we need, in trying to address the crucial problems we have right now, the crisis we have right now, do we need to include that long-term problem in every discussion? Are we unable to deal with mass unemployment unless we at the same time resolve the question of how we're going to pay for Medicare 10 years, 15 years, 20 years from
now?
Again,
I think you're actually mushing the 2 things together because I'm saying we can do 2 things at once.
But the reality in Washington
isn't connected with the other.
But the reality in Washington has been that we have spent the last almost 3 years talking entirely about deficits, not at all about jobs, about job creation, and we have in fact been cutting discretionary spending severely. What's that about if people are not obsessing about the short-term deficit?
All right.